Over in Indonesia, the police chief of Malang City has been sacked following the deadly stampede at a football stadium over the weekend. The tragedy killed at least 125 people. One group said 32 of the victims were children. On Monday, players from the Arema Football Club gathered at a makeshift memorial outside the stadium to pay their respects. Its president also apologized for the club's role in the tragedy, which unfolded after the team lost to its bitter rival Saturday night. Another breakthrough in Ukraine's counteroffensives against Russian forces. Reuters reports Ukrainian troops have advanced in the southern Kherson region, bursting through the Russian front and threatening Russian supply lines. This is the latest setback for Moscow, which lost control of the eastern logistics hub of Lyman on Sunday. Reports now say the Kremlin has sacked another military commander in Ukraine. This is the latest in a series of top Russian officials to be fired amid a recent string of stinging defeats in its Ukraine offensive. Meanwhile, the detained chief of the Zaporizhia nuclear power plant has been released. This was confirmed by the head of the UN nuclear watchdog. No further details were given. Ihor Murashov was detained by Russian patrol on Friday after leaving the plant. Zaporizhia, Europe's largest nuclear energy facility, has been one of the centers of tension between Kyiv and Moscow. Both have accused each other of launching strikes in the area, raising fears of an atomic disaster. North Korea fires a ballistic missile over Japan, prompting a warning for residents to take cover. Japanese broadcaster NHK reports the government advised residents to stay indoors or take shelter immediately following the launch. The warning has since been canceled. According to Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida, the mid-range missile flew over the country and landed in the Pacific Ocean. South Korea's president, meanwhile, has vowed a stern response to the launch. This is the fifth missile test from Pyongyang in less than 2 weeks. U.S. President Joe Biden visits hurricane-devastated Puerto Rico. Biden announced a $60 million fund to strengthen storm defenses on the island, including flood barricades and warning systems. Thousands of people in the U.S. territory remain without power 2 weeks after Hurricane Fiona's onslaught. At least 25 people have died due to the storm.
We came here in person to show that we're with you. All of America's with you as you receive and recover and rebuild. We have to do more. We have to ensure that when the next hurricane strikes, Puerto Rico is ready. We are not leaving here as long as I'm president until everything. Thank you. I mean this sincerely. Until every single thing that we can do is done.
The Philippines recorded over 16,000 additional COVID infections in the past week, the sixth straight week that reported weekly cases were below 20,000. But Filipinos are still urged to remain vigilant and to keep wearing their face masks even outdoors. Rafael Bosan reports.
With face masks now being optional outdoors, Belen Tumalao, a vendor in Quiapo, has decided to ditch it. She says she's able to work better without obstructions to her airways.
Kasi pag naka-face mask po kasi ako, yun na, kumakahinga, kapinapawisan ng gilid ng ano, parang nabubulol tayo magsalita. Bala ng Panginoon. Basta kumita lang po eh, kahit paano.
The only problem is, even if Quiapo is considered an outdoor space, a huge crowd usually builds up in the area. An officer of the Plaza Miranda Police Precinct admits convincing people to wear their face masks has become a challenge.
Yung iba, may mga piloso po, sasabihin nila na nabasa nila EO3 na hindi na nga nire-require ang paggamit ng face mask. Sa mga pupunta po ng Quiapo, either mamimili po o magsisimba o mamamasyal, sumunod po tayo sa pinag-uutos ng ating batas. Sa EO3 po, maliwanag naman po doon, kahit po nasa labas ng lugar tayo, well ventilated, pero pagka po crowded na, kailangan po natin magsuot ng face mask.
But he's thankful there are those who would rather wear their face masks.
Mas mabuti na po yung ganitong naka-face mask kasi po yung may mga sipon, may mga ubo, para hindi ka mahawa. Mas maganda na yung nag-iingat.
An expert explains that while he supports the optional use of face masks, it should still remain non-negotiable in dense areas and those without adequate ventilation.
We still recommend to wear masks if you are in a crowded places and if you are in a place where there's no good ventilation, For example, you're inside a room with people and there's air conditioned turned on.
The Philippines recorded 16,017 new COVID-19 cases, or an average of 2,288 daily cases from September 26 to October 2. While cases of COVID-19 are observed to be increasing in the National Capital Region and other parts of Luzon, Rabahante projects daily cases to remain around the 2,000 mark. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.